Hello, my friend. Welcome to your sleep story. My name is Stephen Dalton. I'm an Irish storyteller, and it's my great privilege to be the voice that you listen to as you go to sleep tonight. Some of you might remember my Paris by Night story that centers around workers at nighttime, including a baker called Jean-Pierre. Well, I've decided to write an entire story about Jean-Pierre. You don't need to have heard the other story first. And this story centers around a rainy, cozy day at Jean-Pierre's Boulangerie in Paris. I really enjoyed writing this one, and I hope you like it. If you'd like to hear more from Jean-Pierre, let me know in the comments. One small thing. People sometimes ask how they can support my work. One of the ways is through Patreon, and by becoming a patron of my channel, you get exclusive access to stories in advance, and also stories with no music. You can find the link below this video. Okay, let's do the relaxation session now, which will take a few minutes before tonight's sleep story. I'm going to count down from 10 to 1, and as I do, allow yourself to let go more and more. 10. Feel yourself supported in this moment. The support that is offered by your bed, or the floor, or whatever you might be sleeping on. And the earth beneath that. The earth supports us. No matter what height in a building we are at, the earth is always there. It's constant. So feel the support of that, the solidity, and allow that solidity to enable you to let go a little more now. Nine. Feel into your body now. Just notice whatever might be happening in your body. Where are you holding tonight? Are you holding in your feet? Are you holding in your hands? Are you holding in your face? Are you holding in your neck? Do you feel any tingling or any pain? Just notice anything now, and anything you can release or soften a little. Try and allow that to happen now. 8. The day is done. Whatever has been, has been. Whatever will be, will be. In this moment, allow yourself to indulge in the enjoyment that is before you. The opportunity to listen to my voice, bringing you to a place of peace and safety. Whatever thoughts you might have about the day that just was, they won't serve you in this moment. Whatever thoughts you might have about what is to come, they won't serve you in this moment either. So surrender to the moment now. Don't fight the thoughts. Just see them for what they are. Thoughts. And imagine them floating away, like clouds passing through a starry sky. 7. You are safe. You are okay. Allow my voice to be a friend of safety, that will only take you to safe places. Allow my voice to be an anchor, a point of safety to come to as you approach sleep. Know that you are safe and that all is fine. 6. This is your moment. You deserve rest. We all do. So allow that fact to bring you deeper into this moment now, to feel a further softening. 5. There is always peace within you. It is a part of you. It lives within you. It may not always be seen, but it's just waiting to be discovered. Allow yourself to see that peace now within you. Allow yourself to feel that peace within you. 4. Perhaps allow a little gratitude for this moment. Indulge in this moment. Indulge in the coziness of it. Get a little more comfortable if you want. Really snuggle into this moment, for you deserve it. 3. Begin to engage with your imagination now. Begin to see a beautiful old building in the heart of Paris on an autumn rainy night, with a little candle flickering in the window. Begin to allow yourself to be comforted by this place, by this opportunity of enjoying the life of a Parisian boulangerie and the uncomplicated life of Jean-Pierre. 2. You have nowhere to be now. Nowhere to go. 1. Completely letting go now. As I tell you tonight's sleep story. It's a rainy autumn morning. Or is it night? It's so early that it's difficult to tell, and it's still very dark outside. Jean-Pierre is going through his usual routine. He walks ever so quietly over the wooden floorboards of his beautiful, old Parisian building, so as not to waken his wife. He brushes his teeth, puts on his overalls, and quietly walks down the winding staircase that leads all the way from his upstairs apartment to the basement kitchen below his boulangerie. He lights the fires and begins his process of preparing for the day. In the stillness of these pre-dawn hours, Jean-Pierre moves with practiced ease in the basement kitchen. This is, in many ways, the heart of his boulangerie. The old stone walls, seasoned by time and countless loaves of bread, croissants, and baguettes, seem to welcome him into their embrace. He begins by mixing the dough for the baguettes, a ritual he has performed literally thousands and thousands of times. Yet each time with the same reverence and dedication. The flour, water, yeast, and salt come together under his skilled hands. It's a simple alchemy, but it is the foundation of his family's legacy. He enjoys to work at this time. He feels like the world is his own, and he likes to work in quite a dim light. In fact, he likes to do it in a very old-fashioned way, by working in candlelight. And as he works, there's a certain meditative element to this. There is a rhythm as he breathes in and out, in and out. It is in these moments that he feels so grateful for this life that has chosen him. As the dough rests, Jean-Pierre turns his attention to the croissants, a recipe that has been passed down through generations. It is said that many great French presidents have come to eat these croissants as well as great French writers and poets, philosophers, and revolutionaries. The process is intricate and demands precision. Layering the dough with butter, rolling and folding repeatedly to create the delicate layers that will puff up beautifully in the oven. Outside, the rain taps rhythmically against the boulangerie's windows. A gentle soundtrack to Jean-Pierre's early morning endeavors. He moves on to preparing an array of pastries. Pain au chocolat, tarte aux frites, and éclair, each a masterpiece of flavor and craftsmanship. The kitchen fills with the warm, comforting scents of baking dough and melting chocolate. And as the sky gently lightens, the coziness remains, and Jean-Pierre carefully loads the pastries and bread into the oven. The sizzle and warmth that greet him as he opens the oven door are a reminder of the magic that happens in this humble kitchen. He watches over the oven, his face illuminated by the glow. He has a kind face, Jean-Pierre. A man of great stature. He has thick grey hair and deep brown eyes. He doesn't have many wrinkles, despite his age. Only around his eyes, from smiling so much. But his has been a life of great joy and satisfaction in the work that he does, serving his community. As he turns from the oven, for a moment he pauses and looks at the 100-year-old photograph of his grandfather as a young man, standing outside the boulangerie, and he thinks, as he has many times before, about what it might have been like to be alive then and spend time with his grandfather. In the faded photograph, Jean-Pierre's grandfather stands with a proud, confident posture. The streets of Paris that he stands in are a bygone era. The image for Jean-Pierre is a gateway to the past, to a time when the world was different. Yet the essence of the boulangerie remained the same. A place of warmth, community, and culinary artistry. His grandfather, a young baker then, would start his day with the first light of dawn. Paris in those days had a different rhythm, a slower pace, yet the boulangerie was always a hive of activity. He would don his apron, the fabric already bearing the marks of countless hours spent baking, and begin the process of kindling the wood-fired oven. The crackle and heat of the fire were his constant companions. The heart of the boulangerie that needed careful tending. His mornings were spent, much like Jean-Pierre, kneading and shaping dough. The process was a bit more manual in those times. Each baguette and pastry a work of art in itself. The smell of baking bread was a signal to the neighborhood that the day had begun, drawing in early risers, seeking the comfort of freshly baked goods. In those days, as today in some ways, regulars would stop by, not just for bread, but for conversation and connection. His grandfather knew each and every customer by name, their preferences and stories. It made him someone very respected in the community, someone that people turned to for comfort and advice. And the afternoons would bring a slower pace, a time to prepare for the next day and to experiment with new recipes. And now, as Jean-Pierre stands in the present, gazing at the photograph, he feels a little emotional and a deep connection to his grandfather. Now he sets about opening his little boulangerie in the heart of Paris. The rain still falls outside, and as he moves through his opening routine, he looks around the shop. It has hardly changed from the times of my grandfather, he thinks to himself. He feels cozy with this thought, the feeling of family and deep deep-rooted connections running through him. And as he walks over the very same wooden floorboards that his grandfather walked over all those years ago, he begins by lighting the small lamps that are dotted through the shop. Their warm glow casts a soft, inviting light that counters the grayness of the rainy morning outside. The flickering flames dance gently, reflecting off the glass display cases, now filled with an assortment of baked goods. The sight of the pastries, each a small work of art, is a feast for the eyes. The golden crusts of the baguettes, the flaky layers of the croissants, and the glossy sheen of the eclairs all make for a wonderful sight. Next, Jean-Pierre arranges the freshly baked bread on the shelves, the aroma filling the shop and spilling out onto the street. The scent of warm bread is as comforting a smell as it was in the times of his grandfather, and still attracts people to the boulangerie. As he arranges each loaf, his hands move with a gentle and precise rhythm. And the sound of the rain against the windows, the gentle patter, is a soothing backdrop as Jean-Pierre works. He finds himself moving in sync with the rhythm of the rain. And finally, he places a vase of fresh flowers on the counter, a splash of color on this gray day. With the boulangerie now ready to welcome its first customers, Jean-Pierre stands back, a sense of satisfaction and peace filling him. The first customer of the day, a regular, known to Jean-Pierre as Madame Clémentine, enters the boulangerie just as the clock chimes its early hour. She's a gentle soul. Her years show softly on her face, and she's always accompanied by her little dog, a sprightly terrier named Gigi. As they step in from the rain, the warmth of the shop embraces them. "Bonjour, Jean-Pierre," Madame Clémentine greets with a warm smile, shaking off her umbrella Gigi, equally enthusiastic, trots over to Jean-Pierre, who has a special treat waiting for him. A small piece of bread, which he offers with a fond pat. Bonjour, Madame Clémentine. Bonjour, Gigi. Jean-Pierre replies, his face lighting up at their presence. The usual today? He asks, already reaching for the freshly baked baguette and a croissant, knowing well Madame's daily preferences. Oh, yes, please, she responds, her eyes lingering on the array of pastries. You know, Jean-Pierre, every time I step into your boulangerie, I am reminded of the simple joys of life. The smell of your bread, the warmth of this place, it's comforting, especially on a day like today. Jean-Pierre nods, thoughtfully wrapping up her bread. It's the simple things that often bring us the most happiness, he muses. We spend so much time chasing after big moments that we sometimes forget to appreciate the small ones, like a warm chocolate croissant on a rainy day, or the company of a good friend. Madame Clémentine smiles, her eyes twinkling with wisdom and agreement. Exactly, she says, accepting her package. It's moments like these that make life sweet. Gigi barks in agreement, wagging his tail enthusiastically. As they leave the boulangerie, Jean-Pierre watches them go, feeling a sense of fulfillment in the routine exchanges and the small shared moments of the day. He takes great joy in this, in life's simplicity. The next customer to step into the boulangerie is Monsieur Dubois, an elderly gentleman with a wealth of stories from the Paris of yesteryear. His visits are always cherished by Jean-Pierre, not only for his custom, but for the rich history he brings with him. As the bell above the door tinkles, announcing his arrival, Jean-Pierre looks up and greets him with a respectful "Bonjour, Monsieur Dubois." Monsieur Dubois, leaning slightly on his cane, shuffles in with a smile. Bonjour, Jean-Pierre. It's a perfect day for one of your warm baguettes, he says, his voice tinged with the gravel of age. As Jean-Pierre prepares his order, Monsieur Dubois looks around the boulangerie, his gaze lingering on the old photograph of Jean-Pierre's grandfather. Did I ever tell you? I remember your grandfather quite well. I was just a boy then, and he was an old man, but he had the liveliest spirit, he begins, his eyes glinting with the light of old memories. He used to give me a small biscuit every time I came in. I'd watch him work, fascinated by how his hands, though wrinkled and slow, moved with such skill and grace. One day, he told me, "Young man, always remember that the quality of your work reflects the quality of your heart." Those words have stayed with me all of these years. Jean-Pierre listens, a sense of pride swelling in his chest. He was a wise man, my grandfather. I try to keep his spirit alive in everything I do here, he responds, handing Monsieur Dubois his baguette. Monsieur Dubois takes the baguette with a nod of appreciation. "You've done well, Jean-Pierre. This boulangerie is more than a shop. It's a piece of history, a piece of all our lives here in Paris." And with a final wave and a merci, Monsieur Dubois steps back out into the rain, leaving Jean-Pierre with a great feeling of purpose and connection to his grandfather. As Jean-Pierre waits for his next customer, he opens a well-worn book, a collection of musings by the renowned French philosopher Michel de Montaigne. The pages, yellowed with age, hold much wisdom that Jean-Pierre finds solace in during these quiet moments in his boulangerie. He reads, and the words play out in his ears. "The true art of living is found in savoring the present moment. We often wander in the mazes of future worries or past regrets, yet the only reality is here and now." "Life," he writes, "is an endless journey of learning and discovery. Each person we meet, each experience we encounter, is an opportunity to grow in wisdom and compassion. Our greatest teacher is the everyday, the ordinary, which, when looked at with curiosity and openness, reveals the extraordinary. In embracing our own perfections, we find the beauty of our humanity. We are works in progress, each with our own flaws and strengths. It is in accepting ourselves and others with kindness and grace that we find true peace and fulfillment. Closing the book, Jean-Pierre reflects on these words. He sees his own life and work in the boulangerie as part of a larger, beautiful whole. With renewed appreciation for the simplicity of this moment, he awaits his next customer, ready to offer not just bread, but a warm presence and a welcoming embrace of kindness. The evening is setting in now, and the rain is still falling. And Jean-Pierre is closing the boulangerie for the day. It's been a day filled with the usual, the comforting routine of baking and serving. Each customer bringing their own story into the boulangerie. Just as Jean-Pierre is about to turn the sign on the door to closed or fermé, the bell tinkles, announcing the arrival of one last customer. He looks up to see a young girl, no more than 8 years old, standing shyly at the entrance, her eyes wide with wonder at the array of pastries still on display. In her hands, she clutches a small, crumpled note. "Bonsoir, monsieur," she says in a timid voice. "My maman sent me to buy a baguette and a tart. She says your tarts are the best in all of Paris." Jean-Pierre can't help but smile at this little girl's earnestness. He fetches the very last baguette left in the boulangerie and one of the last tarts, placing them carefully in a bag. "And what is your name, young mademoiselle?" he asks gently. I'm Sophie, she replies, her shyness giving way to a smile as she takes the bag. Merci beaucoup, monsieur. As she turns to leave, Jean-Pierre feels a surge of joy and fulfillment. It's interactions like these, simple yet meaningful, that remind him why he loves his work. This boulangerie is his life, was his family's life before him, and before them, and before them. He can't survive without it, and it can't survive without him. It's an old friend, and he loves it here. After Sophie leaves, Jean-Pierre takes a moment to savor the quiet of the shop. The sweet scent of pastries, the soft light, the rain still falling outside, and the lingering joy from his interaction with the little girl. And with a contented sigh, Jean-Pierre turns off the lights, locks the door, and makes his way upstairs, already looking forward to another day in his cherished Boulangerie.